Before we can use the encoder, we have to do a few things. First, we have to wire the encoder to the C302. For this example, we'll be using the C302 channel 1A and 1B inputs, and the common is 1M. Now we have to configure the inputs on the C302 module. To do that, we go back to System Configuration, Module Configuration, and we double-click on our module. Click on Configure I/O to set up all the individual I/Os. This one's still set up from before, where we had assigned channel 1's out 0 and 1 to be a step-in direction for our stepper motor. Now we want to add a single quad encoder to the inputs. Well, I just say I want a quad counter. That takes up channels A and B, since we have two wires. And I can even count those encoder pulses as one count per quadrature cycle, two, or even four counts per quadrature cycle. We'll leave it at one right now to keep things simple. And that's all there is to configuring the C302 module. We have our outputs and our inputs, so we hit OK, OK, and OK. So we've wired the C302 for the encoder, and we configured the C302 I/O. Now we just use it. To enable the encoder, you just go into the configuration block and tell it which C302 channel to use. We wired ours to channel 1, so we should probably use that one. Now here's a key point. It's rare that your encoder pulses per revolution will match your stepper PPR. So right here, you need to put the ratio of the two. Divide the motor PPR by the encoder PPR, just like it says in the parentheses here, and put that number here. In our example, we have a 20,000 PPR motor divided by a 360 PPR encoder. So our ratio is going to be 55.56. Because of that mismatch, the C3PO can't always get exactly the right number of pulses it needs, and it'll try and bounce back and forth between the count on either side of perfect. You can eliminate that jitter by specifying a dead band right here. We're not going to fool with that in this demo, but just know you have it available. Also know that these don't have to be constants. You could put registers here and then change both of these on the fly as the program's running. Again, we don't need to mess with that right now. So all we did was check our encoder channel, which looks like I missed, channel 1, and we set up our ratio of the motor PPR to the encoder PPR. Now that the config block has told the C3PO how to handle the encoder, we just use it. For this demo, we'll just use a trapezoid function, and nothing changes. We use the same C3PO module, we're still going to do a relative move, and we're going to specify a target position to be put in D0, so no changes required there at all. Okay, now this is important. Now that we've enabled the encoder in our config block, all positions you use with the CTAX commands need to be in encoder PPRs. Using this trapezoid function, let's move the carriage 10 shaft rotations. Remember, in a previous video, that took 200,000 pulses. Now that we have encoders enabled, we only need 3,600 pulses. Notice down here I added some more logic for our convenience. If X7 is on, we're going to put 3,600 into D0. If X7 is off, we're going to put a minus 3,600 into D0. That just gives me a convenient way to flip back and forth. I'm going to turn on X7, which will write a plus 3,600 D0. And now when we set X0, we expect the carriage to move 10 shaft rotations. And sure enough, it does. And since this was a relative move, I can do it again. Turn X7 off, which writes a minus 3,600 to D0. Now when I engage X0, the carriage moves back. But again, it moves back 3,600 pulses, not 200,000, because we're using encoders. Note that while we use the trapezoid function in this example, these comments apply to all of the CTAX commands on the C302. Well, that's all there is to using encoders with the C302 and a Do More processor. The Do More Designer software makes it easy, and it just works the way you expect it to. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series for more on using Motion. And as always, please send us any comments you may have. We appreciate the feedback. Spend less, do more. From Automation Direct.